Graduates, please be seated. Let's give him a hand to walk in. Good evening, and welcome to the 56th annual commencement exercises of Brebeuf Jesuit Preparatory School. My name is Greg Van Slambrook. I'm the principal. I'm joined on stage by Father Bill Verbreich, the president. And on behalf of our faculty and staff, we wish a heartfelt and joyful welcome to all of our graduates and to our guests. It's very gratifying to be able to gather here all together as a class with your families and guests all in one place. This academic year has been one to remember. And I want you to know that we will remember you, the class of 2021, as a group that demonstrated tenacity, adaptability, and support for each other through significant obstacles. So thank you all for being here tonight to honor this great group of young people. For our national anthem, I'm going to invite up to stage Nate Bingman from the class of 2021. Nate is attending the Virginia Military Institute, VMI, this fall, and in recognition and thanks to his upcoming service to our country, we've asked Nate to present the colors for the playing of our national anthem. At the conclusion of our national anthem, you'll remain standing for the invocation, which will be given by campus minister, Ms. Bree Ballard. Please stand.
Let us take a moment to remember that we are in the presence of God. God, our creator and source of all blessings, we gather this day in gratitude for all you have accomplished through this time of academic pursuits and personal fulfillment in these men and women who graduate today. We ask your continued blessing upon them as we acknowledge your great love for them through those who have supported them through this journey of studies and personal growth, especially the constant support and love of family and friends, and through the guidance and instruction of the faculty and staff of Brebeuf Jesuit. We pray in this blessing that they continue to be people of learning and reflection, integrity and achievement, in solidarity for and with others, that they take with them great desires and dreams to conquer the challenges in our world that is increasingly diverse, complex, and interdependent. That as they pursue their dreams in unexpected ways, they are bold, courageous, and brave, moving beyond fear and doubt to find strength in their capacity to care for others, trusting in the slow work of God. We pray our graduates are filled with courage and strength, that they may be light to their friends and neighbors as they become members of new communities, taking new steps towards their future. We ask for your almighty hand to be upon all those who graduate today. Bless their lives from this day on with goodness and love. Help them to stay true to their dreams, to use their gifts wisely, and to walk into the future with faith, hope, and great love. Amen.
Thank you, Bree. Please be seated. Next, we'd like to recognize our faculty and staff. I know how much the class of 2021 appreciates the teachers, the counselors, all of you who have been here for them. Our Brebeuf Jesuit faculty and staff stepped up this year in a big way for you. So please show them your thanks as I'll ask now for the entire faculty and staff to stand and be recognized. Most of them are over in the wings here. We're also pleased that several of the members of our Board of Trustees are able to join us this evening. Our volunteer board is entrusted with the mission, the values, and the viability of this institution, and they have given us outstanding leadership and support over this past year. Would the members of the Board of Trustees in attendance please stand and be recognized? Thank you. Next, the class of 2021 is proud to present their commencement speaker. Each year, our student speaker is selected based on the nominations of the class, followed by an audition process. Our speaker this year is an outstanding young man, and it was clear to all of us since his freshman year that he possesses a depth and wisdom beyond his years. Please join me in welcoming to the podium Anthony Gomez.
I was hoping he'd do some filler for me, but I guess not. All right, my name is Anthony Gomez from the class of 2021, and firstly, I'd like to thank Mr. Van Slambrook for inviting me to speak this evening. And I think it's appropriate that we start off with another big round of applause for our faculty and staff for getting us through COVID-19 and for making this ceremony possible. When I was asked to speak about the class of 2021, I was honored to say the absolute least. And I thought it necessary to look back to 2017, where I was reminded of a freshman class whose souls were saturated with hope and optimism, whose dreams outnumbered and outweighed their obstacles. I look back to see a freshman class whose unrelenting fascination with the world and its possibilities filled their classroom with discussion, problem solving, and understanding. See, I look back to see a freshman class that wouldn't take no for an answer. Unless, of course, that no came from Dean Adams. You see, I look back at that class and I can't help but ask myself, are we any different now? And of course, the answer is yes, but only in the ways that make us better people. You see, we've experienced a lot these last 4 years. We fought hard, and yet the hand of academic rigor never once loosened its grip. Freshman year, we danced to our first snowball. We stomped on the stands at our first pep rally. Some of you probably attended your first football game, and who knows, maybe you, for the first time, saw the glow of the Friday night lights sparkle in the face of your first love. First relationships, first exams, first speeches, first labs, first time for every little thing, and here we are. See, never overlook the significance of that path of first times, because one day, unknowingly, you'll do those things for the last time. See, I like to think I changed a lot these last 4 years. I mean, I stumbled in this place with a fake gold chain, chronic facial acne, and a bad haircut. Yeah, shout out Proactive. I'm not sponsored, but I should be. But I had no idea how fulfilled, challenged, and ultimately accepted I'd feel within the next 4 years. One lesson in particular that I learned from my late father, whose absence I regret immensely from this ceremony, was to not live a half life. And this is the message that I'd like to leave with you today in particular. A half life is a life lived in fear, and a life lived in fear is a life half lived. Let me say that again. A half life is a life lived in fear, and a life lived in fear is a life half lived. You see, I think that we often glorify the idea of excellence and perfection. But if I'm frank with you, I don't think that that's what life's about. Perfection can never be achieved. And the very second that you leave the walls of your academic institution, your work stops being graded by letters of the alphabet, and they start being graded by how well it contributes to humanity. Perfection cannot be achieved, but competence can. Competence is your ability to consistently deliver skilled and honest work. It is your ability to understand the material in front of you and consistently deliver. The solutions that humanity needs, that your brothers and sisters need, we must understand that it takes both passion and competence to be unstoppable. These are the only two instruments that are essential to your success. You've already got the passion. I've seen it. We've all seen it. But now it's time to focus. Because when you accept a path that another person pays for you, you end up stopping halfway and you're stranded. And it's here where I'm reminded of a quotation by the great poet Galil Gibran, where he says, "Do not love half lovers. Do not entertain half friends. Do not indulge in the works of the half talented. Do not live a half life and do not die a half death. If you choose silence, then be silent. When you speak, do so until you are finished. Do not silence yourself to say something." And if there's one lesson I think Brebeuf's legacy can leave with us, it's to never silence yourself. Remember that freshman class I was just talking about? Well, I see them all here right now. I see a group of people whose trials have not defeated them. I see a group of people whose hearts want more than to just be seen, whose words deserve more than to just be heard. You all know yourselves better than the world does, and that is okay. Because right now I see people ready to live full lives, ready to accept with enthusiasm every opportunity to create justice, innovation, ingenuity, pride, and integrity. I see people ready to do so in the name of love. Not for a check. Not for money, not for comfort, not for tranquility's sake. I see a senior class that's about to live the fullest life that they can, and to that I say beautiful. Just look inside. Inside every single one of you is a lingering silhouette of the person that you want to be, dancing inside of the heart of your conscience, desperate to break out and sing that precious song. I know you feel it. Because that's the pulse of God's infinite love making its way through your veins as you grace your communities with your priceless insight. And I gotta say that this class, if any class, will be the ones to allow themselves to change the world, to allow yourselves to make that mark. Because every intellectual capability necessary to understand the world's mechanisms already exists inside every single one of you. But just like an orchid can't grow in a bed of sand, your knowledge cannot change the world without competence and compassion. None of you are perfect. Yes, not even you, Sean Mishra. But none of you let that stop you from solving the problems that you see in the world. And if someone were to ask me candidly, what do you find endearing about the class of 2021, that would certainly be my response. Ladies, gentlemen, and those of you in between, if I may for a moment revisit the ever so eloquent words of Khalil Gibran. He says, "Your other half is not the one you love. It is you in another time, yet in the same space. It is you when you are not. It is a word you have not said, a smile you have postponed, a love you have not had, a friendship you did not know. Half a life is a life that you did not live." To the class of 2021, on behalf of myself, the faculty, staff, the student body, everyone in attendance, congratulations, we become graduates today. Thank you very much. enough, that's enough. But before I leave, there is some bad news. It seems Chief got into the diplomas and he thought that they were chew toys, so we're gonna have to come back here next week and try this again.
Anthony Gomez. Next, it's a Brebeuf tradition for the graduating class to present a gift to the school on behalf of the class. So please welcome up our senior class officers, Caroline Potts and Jesse Singh, to make that presentation.
Good evening. My name is Caroline Potts.
And my name is Jesse Singh. Together, we served as the senior class presidents for this school year.
As the school year began, we were prepared for a year that would be different from years past. This expectation was met early on when an election tie resulted in Brebeuf's first ever senior class co-presidents. Adaptation to a new normal became our goal for helping our class get the most out of their senior year.
Our student council worked hard during this unprecedented year to present our class with fun and safe activities that would bring our class together, including creating a class shirt and sweatshirt, organizing a class-wide game of Kahoot, holding an epic battle of senior assassins, and closing out the year with an eventful senior week.
Our academic year was affected by the constraints of COVID restrictions. We had to adapt to virtual learning, hybrid learning, modified classrooms, social distancing, and masks. Through these difficulties, all of Brebeuf's students, faculty, and administration worked hard to preserve our education and keep the Brebeuf community strong.
As many of you know, the duty of the Senior Student Council every year is to select a gift from our grade to give back to the school. With our budget, we considered many different options and various things that our school needs. We wanted to select a gift that would be reflective of the class of 2021, but would also have utility and contribute to the everyday lives of students. It is no secret among us that our high school experience has been less than normal. Amongst the social distancing requirements and limited space inside the school, many of us found comfort spending our time outside rather than inside the building. Our class gift truly reflects our journey alongside COVID-19.
That's why, as our gift, the class of 2021 is giving a brand new picnic table made out of recycled materials to the school to be placed outside of the gym lobby. We hope this will be used by future Brebeuf students to gather for outdoor learning, enjoy group lunches, and make fun memories.
In closing, Caroline and I would like to thank each student for being a part of this senior class and for all of the hard work everyone has done to make this year memorable for everyone. We are all truly unique in every way imaginable, and without all of our differences, our class would not be as special as it is. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, class of 2021. Being outside on beautiful days is one of the silver linings to things this year, so it's a very appropriate gift. Next, please welcome for his remarks the chair of the Brebeuf Jesuit Board of Trustees, Mr. Dan Lechleiter, who's a member of the Brebeuf class of 1997.
Good evening and welcome, everyone. Mr. Gomez, you're an incredibly tough act to follow. Well done. I'd like to give him another round of applause. Well, I'd like to especially welcome our 2021 graduates. I'm honored to have you as my newest fellow Brebeuf alumni. Very thankfully, we are blessed with a beautiful evening, warm spring weather, which I think is a most fitting environment in which to celebrate you, our 2021 graduates. You've earned this evening in so many ways. As you know so well, your final years at Brebeuf coincided with and were altered inextricably by a most extraordinary time, a global pandemic, quarantines, travel bans, canceled athletic seasons, maroon, gold, and silver cohorts. And for so many parents, including my wife and me, perhaps the clearest, direst, and most ominous sign that the apocalypse must be approaching: e-learning. Yet despite all of the many challenges and the obstacles that were far beyond your control, you made it. You did it. You're here. No one will ever be able to say that the class of 2021 lacks tremendous fortitude and resilience. It has been a special privilege and my great honor to have served on the Brebeuf Board of Trustees for 9 of the last 10 years, and as chairman for the past 2. As my time as chairman draws to a close, I have found myself reflecting not only on my board service, but perhaps even more on the unexpected twists and turns and the winding roads I traveled to get here, and the many important lessons I've learned and tools I've picked up on the journey. I'd like to briefly discuss one of those with you this evening. I'm a proud 1997 graduate of Brebeuf. When I graduated, much like you, I expect, I was excited to move on to the next phase of life, college and beyond. But of course, as smart and mature as I thought I was, when I left Brebeuf, in reality, I simply had no idea what the world had in store for me. No surprise now, but I soon learned that I still had a lot to learn and a long way to go on the road to adulthood. But throughout that journey, I have held on to and found myself coming back to, time and again, perhaps the most important lesson that I learned at Brebeuf. You, Brebeuf graduates, we are men and women for others. Men and women for others. We all know it as Brebeuf's motto, our creed as students, and now alumni of Brebeuf. But I assure you, in my experience, it is far more than that. The principle of becoming, of being men and women for others, may be the single most powerful tool you've added to your ever-expanding toolbox over the last 4 years. It will help guide you long after your years at Brebeuf. More than that, it is a structure you can build upon to change the world around you for the better, in ways both small and unimaginably large. Men and women for others is so powerful precisely because it is so simple. It asks of you only 2 things. First, that you become and be men and women. Second, that you be for others. Becoming and being men and women for others focuses on you. It implies an acknowledgement not of gender, but of the significant growth, development, and spiritual formation you've experienced and the maturity you've gained over the last 4 years. You entered Brebeuf as seniors in the adolescent world, and you leave as freshmen in the adult world. Not just because you were 4 years older, but because the depth and breadth of your experiences here has refined, honed, and matured your characters. In that sense, and although you will, of course, continue to be shaped and formed by the many experiences that lie before you, you truly leave Brebeuf as young men and women. Yet the primary focus of men and women for others is, by any measure, others. It takes great maturity and tremendous strength of character to put oneself and one's own self-interest aside and truly be a man or woman for others, to truly serve others. But I believe it takes a great deal more than that. First and foremost, being for others takes knowing and being true to yourself, your values, your ethics, your morals, and your spiritual beliefs. You must know what you stand for and believe, what you will stand up for, before you can effectively stand up for others. It takes a willingness to step into someone else's shoes, and not only attempt to see, but understand things from their perspective. Being for others is not an abstract exercise, but it is perhaps at its most concrete when you truly understand those around you, what they need the most, and how you can best bring to bear your unique skills and special talents to help address those needs. Being for others takes independent thinking and critical questioning. At a time in which the news media and social media often seamlessly blend fact, opinion, and conclusion, you must strive to dig deeper, to look beyond the surface, to seek a true understanding of the world and events around you. To do this, you must equip yourself with the right tools. Doubt what seems doubtful. Ask questions. Do your level best to understand both sides of a debate. Disagree without being disagreeable. Seek out new and diverse perspectives and advice. Take the time to think through and discern carefully and prayerfully the right option among difficult choices. Embrace new ways of thinking, and be wary of those who might insist on telling you what to think instead of teaching you how. It is only once you are armed with the truth that you will be able to navigate the many gray aspects of our world without trepidation and can most effectively be a man or woman for others. It takes making decisions based on what you know and understand to be right, and I assure you this will rarely be easy. We've all heard much about peer pressure. Peer pressure is by no means a creature you leave behind when you leave high school. It will change forms, be known by different names, and be ever presently lurking around you. Being for others will require that you resist what may be the popular course, but that you know to be wrong. Being for others takes not only a willingness to act, but action on behalf of and for the benefit of others. For over 50 years, my wife's great uncle Ben was a businessman and extraordinary community servant in his adopted hometown of Nashville, Tennessee. When he recently passed away, his obituary included a powerful exhortation, a statement of his own that not only perfectly captured him as a person and how he lived his life, but what I found to be perhaps a fundamental truth for us all. Our lives are not defined by what we believe. Our lives are defined by those actions we take about what we believe. But as great Uncle Ben would probably also want all of you to remember, use your judgment. Most actions have a time and a place. Some have neither. Finally, you must earnestly continue your growth and development as men and women. It is truly an iterative journey. The more your character as a young adult grows and matures, the more effectively you can be for others. And this is perhaps the simplest part. Never stop learning. Seek to educate yourselves at the highest levels so that you can not only educate others, but truly be an advocate for others. It's been a great privilege to be able to share a few words with you this evening. Graduates, my sincere congratulations to all of you, and I wish you the best of luck and Godspeed as you proceed. Out into the world as Brebeuf alumni, and out to change the world for the better as men and women for others. Thank you.
At this point in the evening, we have a few awards to present. Our first award is the Econ Educator Award, selected and presented by the Brebeuf Jesuit Alumni Association. And representing the Alumni Association is Aaron Moore, class of 2002, who's making her way up now.
Good evening, and congratulations. Father Bill, Mr. Vanslandbrook, thank you for inviting me as the representative of Brebeuf Jesuit Alumni Association. Graduates, let me be the first to congratulate you on your graduation and welcome you to a very exclusive group, the Brebeuf Alumni Association. Please, as your continued success takes you around the country and the world, stay in touch. I am humbled to be here to present the 2020 and 2021 Echelon Educator Award recipients. The Echelon Educator Award is presented each year by the Alumni Board of Directors to a current or former faculty or staff member who exemplifies the Ignatian principles and values of a Jesuit education. We want to first honor and celebrate our 2020 Echelon Award winner, as we were unable to last year at graduation. The 2020 Echelon Award recipient has served in the Brebeuf Science Department for over 40 years. When she began teaching at Brebeuf, freshman biology course consisted mostly of lectures, and AP Bio was not even an offering. She has been instrumental in the development of Brebeuf Science Department over the years and played a key role in the recent updates to the science wing. Throughout her time at Brebeuf, she has been very involved with the community by serving as a department chair, chess club moderator, National Honor Society moderator, student council moderator, and always being an avid supporter of Brebeuf volleyball program. The 2020 Echelon Educator Award recipient is Miss Hattie Hatfield. Hattie's standing over there. Thanks for congratulating her with us. Thank you, Hattie, for sharing your friendly smile and dedication with the Brebeuf community. We are so grateful that you have done to enrich the educational experiences of so many Braves, including myself. This year, the board nominated a teacher that has taught many of us, again, me too, during our time at Brebeuf, who we wanted to recognize for the many outstanding lessons he taught us over the years. This year's recipient was missioned to Brebeuf as a Jesuit brother in a part-time role as an art teacher and campus minister. At the urging of the principal, he expanded the art program and became a full-time staff member. After 3 years, he decided to leave the Society of Jesus, but remained in his ministry as a teacher at Brebeuf. He has served the Brebeuf Jesuit community in the art department for nearly 30 years. He is quiet in nature, but always willing to help others, and is an excellent example of how to serve with Ignatian principles. Thank you, Joe, for inspiring and leading so many minds over your years at Brebeuf. This year's Echelon Educator Award recipient is Mr. Joe Winhuizen.
Thank you, Ms. Moore, and congratulations, Hattie and Joe. All the rest of our awards that we'll do this evening start with a nomination process, like our speaker did, where we ask our seniors to name who they would select for each award, and the final awardees are selected from those nominations by a committee of faculty and staff. When I call your name for an award, please come forward up on the stage. You'll receive a certificate with your award from Father Bill. The Ignatian Educator Award honors a member of our faculty or staff who exemplifies the characteristics of an Ignatian educator. Our awardee tonight has been a social studies teacher at Brebeuf for 12 years. He is beloved by students for his humor, his warmth, for his habit of walking around the halls all day with a golf club, looking like he's ready to hit an approach shot, but really just because he loves interacting with students every chance he gets. As an Ignatian educator, he wears his heart on his sleeve, challenges his students to make their learning authentic and real for their lives. I'm pleased to present this year's Ignatian Educator Award to Mr. Matt Mayer. He's running from the back. He's coming right through the middle of the student section. Now for the first of our student awards, we have the Community Service Award. This award is presented to a senior student who goes far above and beyond the typical service requirements of a Brebeuf Jesuit student. This year's recipient has stood out since her freshman year for her leadership on behalf of the Humane Society and many others, and has continuously built on that over the 4 years to be known among her class for her heart and her commitment to others. Our Community Service Award recipient is Sophia Pruitt. The Leadership Award is presented to a student or students who have served as a great leader for his or her class and for Brebeuf Jesuit as a whole. One of our recipients this year showed remarkable leadership skills in mobilizing and coordinating the movement for racial equity in the entire Indianapolis community and beyond. The other brought a true spirit of servant leadership for his class and for the student body as a whole, earning the respect of his peers for his humility and his work ethic. Congratulations to our two Leadership Award recipients, Sadia Anderson and Eli Franklin. The Brother John Buckman Award annually recognizes a student and a staff member, both, who exemplify the characteristics of Brother John Buckman, nicknamed Bucky, who served the school lovingly and selflessly from 1971 until his retirement in 2010. This is an award meant for a behind-the-scenes leader or someone who goes above and beyond without regard for credit or attention. Our student recipients of the Bucky Award are nominated by their peers as people who both get a lot done, are extremely talented, who are always willing to put their skills to use on behalf of others with striking humility, which you really feel from them, and that's the true spirit of this award. Congratulations to Sean Mishra and Anna Ramirez. Our staff recipient of the Bucky Award, we select a staff recipient each year. She's served Brebeuf in various capacities for 14 years. Over that time, she's been a go-to servant leader for many, many of our faculty and staff members as a mentor, an advisor, and a listening ear. She's been one of our school's main experts on Ignatian education and Ignatian spirituality, and has become widely known in the Jesuit school world beyond Brebeuf for her leadership in those areas. And as a result, it's bittersweet to say that she's moving on and up over the summer into a regional leadership role for the Midwest Jesuit province. Congratulations to Jen LeMaster. Our two awardees were recognized by their peers for their 4 years of energy and enthusiasm that they brought to our cheering sections. Congratulations to Joe Fisher and Nosa Imaswen. And our last student awards of the evening is our highest honor from the class called the Grad at Grad Award. The Grad at Grad Award is presented to those who most clearly model those five characteristics we are trying to develop in Jesuit education of being intellectually competent, open to growth, religious, loving, and committed to justice. We have three very deserving recipients of this award from their class this evening. I love how all three of our recipients are admired by their classmates for both their talents and for their big hearts. They're each exceptionally well-rounded, have big resumes of accomplishments over the 4 years, and obviously have many more to come in their future. And they're also exceptionally open to growth, eager to learn more, to serve, and to make an impact on the world. Congratulations, and come forward to Emily Doring, Parker Miller, and Henry Champ. At this time, please welcome to the podium for his remarks, Father Bill Verbraeck.
No, I'm fine, thank you. First of all, again, welcome to the graduates, welcome to their family and their friends. This really has been, as we say often, a remarkably challenging year. And as I said this morning, this is a class that I am grateful that we had to help us move through this very challenging time. You have great hearts, you have accomplished much, and you have been there for each other. And what I like to focus on in my own reflections as we go through graduation are relationships. And I think we all form strong relationships that we hope we can build on even beyond graduation. And I think, as you have heard from Aaron Moore and from Dan Lechleiter, that is very true for them. They are graduates who continue to stay involved with Brebeuf Jesuit. Faculty and staff, too, also focus on relationships. And one of the things that I have valued when I came to Brebeuf is the sense that the faculty and the staff really are here for the students. I have been in some schools where there have been great educators, but I have not felt that sense of relationship in a school before. And that is because they care for the students, they care for their peers, they care that our mission is accomplished. For me too, I focus on relationships. And November 16th and 17th, 2017, I was part of a small group for a freshman retreat. If you count back, that was your class as freshmen. And if you have ever been in my office, I have a poster hanging up. And if you take a look at it, I'm not sure what you would think of it. But it was a poster that was made by Group 4 on that retreat. And it moved me because of what I experienced being in that group with them. And what the poster is, it's our reflection for that retreat. Our small group was given the task of preparing the reflection for the prayer service. And we had very limited amount of time to come up with the topic and also how we would present it. I was so impressed with this small group, how they came together. And this part, I don't think they realize. I told Bree Haler, I think, who was leading that retreat, don't expect much from us because we had such a short amount of time. I'm going to get that poster now. Those of you in the way back will not be able to really see what is on it. very simple. What they decided to do was take the word Brebeuf and to come up with words with letters from those letters and sort of describe what their experience had been at Brebeuf to that point. I would like to invite the group four members to please come forward now. As they're walking up, let me tell you what their words were. For the B, it was blessed. For the R, it was refreshing. For the E, it was the word heart. For the B, it was collaborate. For the E, it was enlight. For the U, it was you. And for the F, it was faith. And what I thought early on was, I'm going to use this when they graduate. And now they are graduates. So I called them together last Friday, and I asked them, let's do something with this poster. Would you like to review those words to explain how that has been part of your experience for the 4 years? They said, no. Let's do it differently. Of course, they're independent. What they chose to do was to come up with their new words. And Kate Christ, who was one of the fabulous designers of the original one, came up with this in short order. So what I'm going to have them do is to very briefly explain to you why these words are significant to them as graduating seniors. Should we start with the B? And do you want to do both words now or wait till the other one? Okay.
So our first word is brave. Bravery means doing what is difficult and may make you stand out, but what is necessary. Bravery and courage have been displayed impressively during the class of 2021's time here at Brebeuf. Brave are the members of our community and administration who protected our valued educators when their jobs were threatened in the summer of 2019. Brave are our classmates who are not afraid to share their personal stories and experiences and to speak out.
Our first word was refreshing. When we came to Brebeuf as freshmen, we felt refreshed by the environment here. There were so many new opportunities and people that we could surround ourselves with. And having so many options was a little overwhelming, but mostly liberating. Our second word was refined. In our 4 years here, we've used these opportunities to grow as people. We've learned a lot about our likes and dislikes and refined ourselves, academically or otherwise.
All right, asked for the first of two E's, I apologize. Thinking back to who we were as freshmen and the expectations we had for Brebeuf and the curriculum, back to wondering what it would truly be like to experience a college preparatory education in action. Rather than simply growing through our processes of learning, what I found is that our greatest growth is rooted in all that is interpersonal and humanized. So despite our devotion to prestige and ambition in academia at Brebeuf, and of course our excellence in those areas, we leave here with an unanticipated abundance of preparedness for social, emotional, and spiritual occurrences documented by the word educated.
The second B is for balanced. The five graduate grads that were mentioned earlier outline the values that Brebeuf students should embody by the time they make it to where we are today. Open to growth. Intellectually competent, loving, religious, and committed to promoting justice. These contribute to a balanced character and a balanced person.
Now for the second of two E's. Entering the domain of a school as small and intimate as Brebeuf can be, we're challenged to take advantage of our chances for reflection and chances for derivation of meaning. Not only in the situations that challenge our spirit, but also in moments that fulfill our higher purposes. In the instances we are forced to shift our paradigms of the world, such as within our small groups on retreat, we develop our skills of empathy in order to create comfort in a space of vulnerability. And by going on retreat each year, we are graced with a moment to check in with ourselves on how well we have paid attention to what goes on within our own mind and heart, and consequently, whether we're healthy enough to emotionally be better people for others. These moments call us to embody empathy and operate out of love rather than fear.
Okay, so for the you, we went from you to ubiquitous. So we came to Brebeuf as individuals, and through our 4 years, we have recognized our commonalities and friendships as braves. In this way, we will always be connected, no matter the distance between us. The omnipresence of the Gradit grads and ideology of men and women for others is something we can all take with us in our next chapter. While our physical presence at the school is ending, the spiritual nature and mentality of being brave doesn't end here, and we can see the gifts and talents of Brebeuf in all aspects of our lives beyond this chapter of our lives. Being a brave is ubiquitous, no matter your journey.
So lastly, both Fs on the posters stood for faith. So as freshmen, Brebeuf invited us to share aspects of who we are, such as our view of the world, the characteristics that defined us, and most importantly, the faith in what we believe, both individually and as a community. Now, as we graduate together, we see that we have evolved into stronger, more refined, and more authentic people overall. As we have learned to accept and respect the different perspectives each of us has for our own. As we as individuals have changed, our faith as a community has remained constant, shaping us into the Gradit grads who stand before you today. While we have certainly endured challenges in the past year, our faithful dependency on one another, both as a class and as a community, has helped us persevere and get us to where we are today. Thank you.
Thank you, Group 4, and these are my remarks for this evening. Thank you, thank you.
It is now that time to present each of the members of the class of 2021 for their walk across the stage. Graduates, you'll be led by Dean Adams. We'll direct each row. Starting alphabetically, we'll give her a second to move them into line here. As I read your names, you'll be coming up across and receiving your diploma cover from Father Bill. There will be, for obvious reasons, no handshaking or hugging at this one. Just receive your diploma. Pause for a photo. Photo hold there, there you go. Perfect. And we'll ask that all members of the audience hold your applause until all of our graduates' names have been read. Make sure that we can hear each name and give it the respect it deserves. Fogo Folua Enereasi Akinyula. Rafael Savelli Alessandri. Evan Michael Altman. Evan will also be presented his diploma by his mother, member of our Board of Trustees, Ms. Kelly Altman. Sadia Lael Anderson. Alexandra Marie Anglin. Gabrielle Lauren Arthur. Kevin Kesley Asu. Jordan Marguerite Bales. Hadley Marie Barr. Ryland Winthrop Barton. Michael Austin Beatty. Rowan Aurora Singh Bagar. Nathaniel Gordon Bingman. Megan Catherine Blanton. Elizabeth Lauren Marie Bourne. Lucy Reagan Borowski. Will Christopher Brower. Clarice Burton Bricker. Claire Helene Bromond. Allison Marie Caffrey. Emily Victoria Case. Linnea Lucille Corielli. Kate Elizabeth Christ. Alluria Divine Daniels. William Paul Dapp. Grayson Francis DeHert. Adam Thomas DeLumpa. Elisa Danielle Derrico Williams. Henna Rajesh Damecha. Julius Darren Dickerson. Emily Helen Doring. Reese Matthew Donovan. Thomas Martin Druck. Delaney Maeve Duffy. Aiden Joseph Duncan. Luke Vincent Eckerly. Reese Patrick England. Austin Cole Ezel. Austin's diploma will be presented by his father, member of our Board of Trustees, Mr. Tony Ezel. Abigail Elizabeth Fenchek. Joseph Eli Fisher. Quinn Ryan Fitzgerald. Isabella Marie Ford. Allison Parker Foster. Kyle Beck Fowler. Eli Gregory Franklin. Greer Evelyn Frazier. Louise Burnett Frazier. Andrew Frederick Gale. Jack Ryan Gall. Melissa Desiree Gamero. Frederick Murphy Garver. Abigail Esther George. Lily Christina Gibson. Gabrielle Marie Godbout. Anthony Alfredo Gomez. Adil Mazam Habib. Aliyah Janae Hackett. Jania Aisha Hackett. Drake Theodore Hagerman. Drake's diploma will be presented by his father, member of the Board of Trustees, Mr. Jeff Hagerman. Annalise Rose Hagnell. Chloe Lynn Hall. Brian Eric Halverson. Sydney Marie Hart. Carson David Hartley. Cole Corin Hartung. Isaac Steiger Howe. Owen Robert Hayden. Xavier Dylan Heggie. Philip Joseph Hess. Harmony Louise Lucinda Hicks. Carly Hilbert. Jennifer Rose Hill. Camille Genevieve Hirschfeld. Anthony James Hobson. Jacob Taylor Horn. Robert Brooks Houseman. Sarah Grace Humbert. Connor Stephen Hungsberg. Haley Elizabeth Hurst. Charles Neil Hutchinson. Nosadeba Edward Imaswin. Anna Maeve Johnson. Colton Anthony Young. Natanya Ida Katz. John Riley Kaufman. Courtney Ryan Kelly. Faizan Jaleel Khan. Daniel Johnson Kirk. Morgan Ashley Kirsch. Quinn Kitchell. Liam Kendrick LeClave. Madeline Marie LeBlanc. Gabriella Reese Lewis. Gabrielle Joan Lindemann. Catherine Olivia Loftus. Sydney Jean Ludwig. Elijah Francis Sumalinog Maramba. Michelle Nicole Markle. Eris Aspasia Martinez Betancourt. David Nicholas Martinez. Valeria Lourdes Martinez. Nathan Jeffrey Mathias. Madeline Jane McLoyan. Johanna Elise McNair. Savannah Alexandria McNeil. Daniel Joseph Melbert. Daniel's diploma will be presented by his sister, Ms. Annie Melbert, who works in our Office of Institutional Advancement. Owen James Mercer. Benjamin Cooper Marisotis. Parker James Miller. Margot Claire Milton. Sean Verma Mishra. Melanie Chardet Mitchell. Caroline Grace Modrell. Sophia Lakshmi Mohan. Matthew Donahue Moore. Jack Riley Maroknik. Mary Sophia Munson. Logan Michael Murray. Genevieve Marie Myers. Jillian Marie Nanagas. Alexander Tariq Nave. Isaac Jamil Nayama. Masvita Anotida and Lovu. Elias Wells Nair. Samuel Alexander Nair. Oyindamola Olutofumi Odelowo. Jackson Dean Oldham. Temi Loluwa Olu Moroti Ocean Token. Heather Marie Parker. Robert Parker Passarelli. Sophia Nilu Patron. John Michael Pavlak. Paola Perillo Parra. Brendan Lawrence Petrie. Andrew Connor Perkle. Ryan Isaac Plaskoff. Jack Henry Poplarski. Xavier Matai Porter. Caroline Ann Potts. Sophia Amelia Pruitt. Alexandra Elizabeth Kweiser. Anna Karen Ramirez. Brittany Melissa Ramos Hernandez. Ethan Thomas Reed. Brianna Reyes Cruz. Andrea Rios Berospe. Laura Magdalena Rodriguez Cardenas. Trevor Jordan Ressler. Trevor's diploma will be presented by his father, Mr. Mick Ressler, from our Visual and Performing Arts Department. Lily Gabrielle Rosenberg. Aiden Stefan Ryan. Kennedy Xinling Seich. Veronica Anastasia Salama. Sophia Maruno Sample. Braden Craig Sanders. Corey Benjamin Savin. Monica Michelle Schaefer. Henry Louis Champ. Isabella Bauer Schumacher. Peyton Nicole Seaman. Sienna Hope Sefton. Morgan Sarah Shine. Casey Grace Sacuso. Mia Rose Simmons. Jasnor Singh. Samuel Matthew Skelton. Stanley Dale Snyder III. Alia Marie Soria. Jaden Hua Sourwine. Isabella Olivia Sonich. Christopher Michael Strawn. Reese Leland Sutherland. Jane Kathleen Swanson. Bridget Scanlon Sweeney. Shannon Kennedy Swenson. Michael Richard Swed. Kaylin Alexandra Toman. Christian Tyler Troop. Carlos James Valadez. Anna Sophia Vargas. Zoe Davis Wade. Liam Patrick Walsh. Anthony Nino Watson. Mina Elizabeth Weber. Sophie McLaren Weber. Nathan Clark Wendowski. Sophia L. Witsit. Rashad Paul Xavier Williams, Jr. Zuri Kwame Williams. Ryan James Wichker. Carson Jean Woods. Emmanuel Basil Jansen. Isabel Marie Zeller. Catherine Mary Zortman. Catherine's going to stay here for a moment. I'm going to ask Mr. Lechleiter to come back and join us. In a moment, Catherine will lead the class in the turning of the tassels and throwing of hats following Mr. Lechleiter's graduation proclamation. So follow Catherine's lead. When he's finished, she'll direct you. Graduates, please stand.
Members of the class of 2021, as the chair of the Board of Trustees, it is my honor to proclaim that you have completed the requirements for graduation from Brebeuf Jesuit Preparatory School. You are hereby entitled to all of the rights and responsibilities that you now have as Brebeuf Jesuit alumni. Congratulations.
You get to take home your hats and tassels. You'll distribute your gowns afterwards. I'll give you instructions in a minute. Make sure you pick up a hat if you haven't already. And I'm going to call forward for our closing benediction. One last time, one last daily examine prayer. As the class has heard at the end of every school day for the past 4 years, and often delivered by this most familiar voice of prayer for the class, Ms. Anna Ramirez. Could everyone please stand?
Good evening, parents and class of 2021. This is Anna Ramirez. Let us take a moment to set ourselves and recall that we're in the presence of God. In God's presence, let us remember the events of these past 4 years. We recall the moments during the years for which we are grateful. We remember that God is in all of these moments. Now, let us consider the challenges we may have faced during these 4 years. We remember that God is present every step of the way to comfort us. Even when we face difficulties, God makes all things possible. Now, we reflect on where we may have fallen short. Recall that God helps us to understand our failings and forgives us. Finally, let us give thanks to our families, faculty, and staff that have gotten us to this day, and let us look forward to the graces God has for us in the next phase of our lives. Amen. Class of 2021, go and set the world on fire.
Please continue the last chance you get here for a long, rousing round of applause for the class of 2021. Oh, but students, you gotta hang on, you gotta stay in your... Oh, they're just excited to be with each other. Okay. Okay, class of 2021. Pause where you are, please, and listen up. Up here. Class of 2021, give me just a second. Give me just a second. Everybody pause up here, up here, up here. Thank you. Class of 2021, I've totally lost them. Please pause and look up here. Class F, as we process out down the middle, as the music begins, you're going to need to make your way back to where we started to deposit your gowns and to pick up your envelopes with the actual diploma with your name on it in it. Music, please begin. Congratulations, everyone. Thank you so much, class of 2021.
Lost them. Yes, sir.